Hey guys, welcome to Tech Ed Today. It's 2020. Happy 2020 to you. We're looking forward this year to shoot 52 videos, constant videos for you guys, our viewers, that you can get to enjoy straight up tech content like this. And we'd sure like your support because we shoot this content for you, our viewers. So if you'd like to support us, go over to our Facebook page and like, go over to our YouTube and subscribe, go over to Instagram and also like our page and get to share our content. And we'll be so much grateful for you guys for your support and your love, and we look forward to a happy 2020 with you guys. So today we're going to be reviewing the Samsung Galaxy A51. It's one of the phones from last year that sold really well. It's interesting statistics that the biggest or the most sold phone of 2019 was the Samsung Galaxy A10, followed by Xiaomi phone, and then third was the Samsung Galaxy A50. So the successor to the A50 was the A50s. And for 2020, they have released the Samsung Galaxy A51. This is Samsung's device for this year, and we also sure hope it's gonna sell as best as the Samsung Galaxy A50 and the A50s sold. So this is the Samsung Galaxy A51. It's an interesting device. We're gonna unbox it shortly. So stay tuned and see the unboxing video for the Samsung Galaxy A51. Get your case, you get the phone itself, you got a 25 watt brick, you get the normal Samsung earphones, you get the type C charger, you get the documents, and you get a SIM card ejector too. So this is what you get with the Samsung Galaxy A51. So the version we have here is the Prism Crush Blue. It's in blue. It comes in three primary colors, the blue, the black, and the white. So they are Prism Crush. You can see the geometric patterns at the back. You cannot maybe well see them clearly. So let's just power on this device and see. So the first interesting thing we will note is that the Samsung Galaxy A51 is powered by Android 10. It comes with Android 10 out of the box. So this is one of the phones from 2019, or rather one of the phones from 2020 that comes with Android 10 out of the box. And this is interesting for you to note. So let's set up. So there we go, this is a Samsung Galaxy A51. It's a 6.5-inch Super AMOLED display. It is a full HD plus resolution kind. I like the fact that the whole punch out at the top here is so little, you can barely see it. It's so minimal. And trust me, this is gonna be the design for most of the phones for 2020. It's gonna come out with punch out. So I like the punch out of the back. It's really small. It's so minimal, but inside there, holds your 32 megapixel selfie shooter. I like the design also at the back. As you can see, it carries the four cameras design. This is the new design for cameras in 2020. The Huawei is gonna get this. The Samsung Galaxy S11 or the S20, as they now is rumored to be called, is gonna get it. All the major phones for 2020 are gonna carry this design for the camera. So expect the camera to look this way, and you better begin to fall in love with it using the Samsung Galaxy A51. So this is a very interesting device. I like it. Let's see what it packs internally.
So let's look at the internals of the Galaxy A51. It's a 6.5-inch Full HD Super AMOLED display. At least it's an LED display. It's an OLED display. It's better than the LCDs out there. Not only that, it also comes with the Exynos 9611 processor. It's an upgrade over the 9610 on the Galaxy A50 and the A50s. So it's gonna perform your tasks very well. As I said, it comes with Android 10 out of the box, so you get to enjoy One UI 2 speed over Android 10, which is gonna be very interesting. It comes with a very small cut out, or what we call the punch out for the selfie. It's very small, very minimal. less interactions, less intrusions, so you get to enjoy all this. I prefer the punch-up over pop-up cameras. Why? Because over time the pop-up mechanism gets to downgrade itself or become way worse, and the phone's bezels are also small. They are smaller than usual, so that's something that you can note. So this is the Samsung Galaxy A51. It comes with four cameras at the back. It comes with a primary 48 megapixel, the 13 megapixel ultra wide, a 5 megapixel telephoto, guess what, that also doubles up as a dedicated macro camera. And together with that is a 5 megapixel depth sensing camera. So we're entering into the age of four cameras on a phone to get to use different angles, to get to shoot different things, and that's interesting. But let's test out the cameras to see how they fare out.
So this is the main camera. You also go to the ultra wide. Has an interesting. So let's test out the macro. One advantage of the macro camera is that it allows you to go deeper and deeper into a shot so that you can take more interesting things. If I were to try this on my hand, the macro gets to take in more detail. So that's the macro camera for you. So it has the primary 48 megapixel, it has the ultra wide on it. Which is very interesting for taking wider landscape photos. It also has the macro for you when you want to go deep into things, and it's hidden into the menu. You can change that. And with all that, it has the depth sensor. The depth sensor is to help you take better portrait shots. When you're taking shots, it blurs out the background. That's what the depth sensing camera is always in for. So those are the four cameras that you have in on the Samsung Galaxy A51. Very interesting cameras. They fare well. We are in a well semi-lit area, but it takes very nice photos, as you can see. And I'd give a plus. Let's try out something that would factor in the depth sensing camera. So as you can see, It's blurring out the background. It's just trying to take the vehicle that I'm trying to capture. And that's the photo. I will be posting up these photos on our Instagram channel.
So as you can see, it's 128 gigabytes and 4 GB of RAM. So that will handle your tasks very, very well. All right, it comes with a 4000 milliampere battery that charges with 15 watts. So that will get you through your day. If you've seen the incredibly amazing Samsung ads, they talk about this with long lasting battery life, and they say this is a battery that would last as long as you would. I'd like to see that, but I hope I've tested out the Samsung Galaxy A50. It does well on a day with full charge. So I'm imagining with 110 and a few tweaks on One UI 2, that this would also last a full day on battery. So I'd like to see how that goes. But that's 4000 milliampere battery on this phone. That's very interesting.
The Samsung Galaxy A51, this is an interesting phone. It's quite an upgrade from the Samsung Galaxy A50. If you're looking for a phone between 27,000 to 30,000, go over to Mobile Hub Kenya on Facebook. You can check them out. They sell this phone. As you can see, it carries the 24-month warranty card from Samsung, so you know it's genuine. You can check them out on Facebook. I'm gonna leave their page in the description. You can get to buy this phone from them and many others. So that was our Samsung Galaxy A51 unboxing and first impressions. On first impression, it looks very nice. And I'm gonna test it out and give you a full review. So please tell us on our comment section if you want to see a full review of this device and ask some of the questions that you'd like to ask for us to test out for you. But this was our unboxing and first impressions video of the Samsung Galaxy A51. And we are impressed. If you like straight up tech content like this, go over to TechEd, like our page on Facebook, like our page also on Instagram, and also subscribe to this channel so that you can get to hear and get to know tech content like this as soon as it comes out. So if you're looking forward to great tech content in 2020, like our page, and we are surely going to keep you posted on the great tech of 2020. And that's a wrap from us at TechEd. We love you guys, and peace out.